Yudiel Rivero, or Osmundo Rivero, one of the 11 suspects in the assassination of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Digamo, recanted his previous confession that he was one of those who planned and executed the assassination of the provincial governor. 9 other people also died in the incident. His lawyer says Rivero is now recanting all 3 previous statements submitted to court.
Well, our clients just wanted to tell the truth to the Filipinos. It's from the very start is that they have no participation or any form of involvement in the alleged slaying of the former Governor Digamo.
In a 5-page counter affidavit, Rivero claims that he was forced to admit to the crime and was even tortured by the police. Rivero also said that he was told to implicate Congressman Arnolfo Teves Jr. as the mastermind behind Digamo's assassination.
On March 5 of this year, he only went to the supposed to be to the police station to report the loss of his motorcycle. Mm-hmm. However, he was not given the chance to talk about the missing a motorcycle, but rather he was arrested by the Provincial Intelligence Unit of the PNP of Negros Oriental. And according to the said police officers who arrested him, he was being pointed to as one of the perpetrators who entered the compound of the Digamos in Pamplona, Negros Oriental.
Rivero also claims that a lawyer for the public attorney's office told him to just give in to the demands of the police. Rivero asserts that he does not know a certain Marvin and also has no connection with Teves. Marvin Miranda, a longtime security aide of Teves, was one of those implicated in the case. Teves's lawyer, attorney Ferdinand Topacio, says that if Rivero's claim that he was tortured is true, it reinforces their allegation that there is a deliberate attempt to frame up the suspended lawmaker. The Philippine National Police declined to comment.
Well, with regards to those investigations of the Gama, no, kung pwede, ayoko muna mag-comment to make it to, so as not to preempt any part of the investigation. Kasi baka mamaya mag-misquote ako or it may cause some negative effect on the investigation. Ipagpaumanhin na lang ko, let the investigation take its course now.
Meanwhile, Rivero also filed a petition for habeas corpus before the Manila Regional Trial Court. He is seeking the release of his wife and 2 kids who he claims were unlawfully detained and deprived of liberty by the Justice Department and the National Bureau of Investigation.
He was also threatened that something bad will happen to his family if he will not quote-unquote cooperate with the investigators.
In a press conference last week, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says that Rivero's family are under the Witness Protection Program, which Rivero himself requested.
Hindi, witness protection yon para iharap sa kanya. Request ni Rivero yan. Hinarap sa kanya yan. Dinala sa kanya. Hindi namin gagawin yun kung hindi niya ni-request yan. I can talk to CHR. Wala kami tinatago dito. We're not hiding anything.
Meanwhile, Remulla told reporters Monday that Rivero's wife does not want to talk to him. The Justice Secretary earlier said that he expects the recantation from the suspects after getting new legal counsels. Jeffrey Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.